Preethi Kasireddy. I'm talking about the EIP 999 debate. Basically, what I want to do is educate the broader community on the debate, because I think the debate didn't just start a month ago, it started 6 months ago, and there's multiple attempts at solving this problem of what happened with the Parity Hack, and kind of looking at it from a broader scope and realizing that this is just not a one-time debate, it's a bigger thing, a bigger solution that we have to figure out for each time we have hard forks.
So decision-making processes, values, things
yes.
like that.
Yes.
Okay, so let's say someone never heard of that hack. Could you tell us just in a short, simple way what happened?
Yeah, basically Parity had a library called the wallet library. I forget the name exact, but it was not initialized properly. So what some random user on the internet was able to do was initialize it and make himself the owner, and then after he became an owner, he was able to do anything with the contract, including self-destruct it, which destroyed that library. And there were hundreds of multi-sig wallets that were relying on that library, and because that library was destroyed, it can no longer those wallets can no longer access their funds.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, what is at the crux of this debate, in your opinion?
I think it's a larger issue of like what. Why do we have hard forks, and what are our core values for determining whether a hard fork makes sense? And like, if we have core values, the people who believe in those core values will come to the right side of the fork, and the people who don't believe it will go on the left side, and that's okay. I think we just need to figure out what our core values are as a community, because we're going to have many, many hard forks in the future, and as long as the people who believe in our core values continue to come along with us in the journey, that's fine.
Do you think there are certain decision-making processes that will make all of this a cleaner situation?
I'm a little bit like, I don't really believe in a global catch-all governance system. If you look at many open source projects, they actually don't have a formal governance system. I don't think it's a requirement.
Right. Okay, great.
Yeah.
So what are you working on other than your talk? I mean, what is your
I'm the founder and CEO of a company called TruStory, which is basically we're building a platform for users to authenticate claims that people are making about whether it's their crypto projects or themselves, and we use stake-based betting to validate these claims.
Excellent.
Yes.
We really
need it.
Not just in crypto, though. In the legal
space. In the world,
space.
Yes. Yeah. Starting with crypto, and then, you know, there's use cases across, like politics, news, etc.
Great. Thank you so much for speaking with us today.
Thank you.